Let me show you the basic types of gyroplanes and what makes them fly. Then you can make a few of your own and decide if you want to try making a forward gliding autogyro. The Whirlybird, entered by Richard New in the second Great International Paper Airplane Contest in 1967, is one of the most famous paper aircraft in history. The Whirlybird is not a true helicopter because it does not have a powered rotor to hover and climb. It is a vertically descending autogyro. An autogyro keeps its lifting blade spinning by moving through the air. A vertically descending autogyro goes down, instead of gliding forward like an airplane. Why does the Whirlybird start spinning? The offset blades, created by the cut and folds, bend up when it is dropped, creating this shape that causes the air to push on it like this, starting the spin. As it spins faster, the blades are pulled down a bit due to centrifugal force. You can also start spin and improve performance by twisting the blades a bit like this. If you do this on a Whirlybird, make sure you twist the edge at the center cut higher so you're not trying to spin the wrong way when the blades bend up. Sometimes blades are a little flimsy. You can stiffen them by creasing them slightly on a sharp edge like this, just behind the leading or forward edge, and again about halfway back, then flattening the folds if they are too sharp to get a slight airfoil curve like this. This may also improve performance a little bit. You can have as many blades as you want. They can be placed around a central shaft like this. It's usually more stable if you put some weight down below. If the craft does not spin when you drop it, twist all the blades a little bit the same amount and the same way. This four-bladed version of the Whirlybird is just cut and folded, with no tape. I'll put the plans on my website at realpaperflight.com and make a video about how to make it. Autogyros can have exotic shapes. My asymmetric autogyro often stays up longer than the Whirlybird and is easier to make, with only two folds. I'll put plans on my website and make a video about how to make it too. The seeds of some trees have a wing to spin like an autogyro. You can imitate this with paper if you are patient. You need to duplicate the shape, curvature, and balance. It spins around the seed as it falls, so it has to balance there, meaning almost all the weight is in the seed. Paper gyrocraft have a lifting surface spinning on a vertical axis, going up and down. Autogyros keep themselves spinning by moving through the air, but they may require a starting spin. Kinetic gyrocraft, like the Frisbee, are thrown with a spin that will keep slowing down due to drag. Paper gyrocraft include discs and rings, plus gyroplanes that have distinct blades, like the Whirlybird, boomerangs, and stars. Some gyrocraft can glide or move forward, but gyroscopic forces may cause them to turn, return, or roll over and crash. A gyroscope is a spinning mass. If you try to tip it in one direction, the spin makes it tip 90 degrees to the tipping force. That is why a top keeps falling in a circle instead of tipping over. When this flying star tries to pitch up because it needs weight in front, it rolls over instead. Sometimes gyroscopic forces make a craft circle back. Gyroscopic forces complicate flying a craft like this, making climbs turn and turns climb or dive into the ground. I'll cover that in a future video about how to make and fly a forward gliding autogyro with a body called a fuselage, under blades spinning on an axle. I'm James Onker, a non-traditional designer and Guinness record setter in paper aviation. To see more, see the comments and links below this video.